Father Christ, God is broken spirit and broken and humble heart, not without despise. To good, O Lord, in your pleasure design, let the walls of Jerusalem be built. Then you will be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness, with offerings and burnt offerings, and they shall bring up bulls on your altar.
These be
Thank you.
thou strength to understand his commandments. Lord, your mercy endures forever. Do not put away from the works of your hands. To you belongs praise, to you belongs a hymn, to you belongs glory. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the age of ages. Amen. Let us complete our morning prayer to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Amen.
Thank you.
in your servant the spirit of moderation, humility, patience, and love. Yes, Lord and King, grant me to see my own faults and not to condemn my brothers and sisters, for you are blessed to the age of ages. Amen. O God, be gracious and have mercy upon me. O God, be gracious to me, a sinner, and have mercy upon me. O God, be gracious to me, a sinner, and have mercy upon me. O God, be gracious to me, a sinner, and have mercy upon me. O those who ask me to mark the Lord today, son, men. O those who ask me to mark the Lord today, son, men. O those who ask me to mark the Lord today, son, men. O those who ask me to mark the Lord today, son, men. O God, be gracious to me, a sinner, have mercy upon me. O God, be gracious to me, a sinner, have mercy upon me. O God, be gracious to me, a sinner. Have mercy upon me. O God, be gracious to me, a sinner, and have mercy upon me. Yes, Lord, and keep grant me to see my own faults, and not to judge my brothers and sisters, for you are blessed in the age of ages. Amen. Glory to our God, glory to you.
Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Good evening to all of you who are watching along. God bless us as we just completed the final bridegroom service of this year's Holy Week. And this evening, most of us are very familiar with one of the main themes, which is a juxtaposition, a contrast between the sinful harlot woman who anointed our Lord's feet with costly ointment and her tears, and one of Christ's 12 disciples, Judas Iscariot. And the church offers us this meditation, reflection on these two individuals for our own edification, for our own renewal of soul, so that we can have hope, so that we can be free and liberated from the bonds of sin. Those choices we have made in our life, those actions and deeds that were contrary to the Lord's teachings, bind us up and make us slaves, as Judas became one. As it so beautifully speaks about in the hymns, how he became a slave of the enemy, Judas, and how the sinful harlot was emancipated, was free and liberated. It is amazing. And these hymns really capture so beautifully, as one of the hymns speaks about the harlot saying, "Undo my debt, I pray you, as I undo my braids. Love me who I'm kissing you, though rightly I am hated." In another hymn, we see how the sinful woman rejoices in pouring out the costly oil, and Judas lost no time in selling off the priceless one. And as she untied her braided hair, Judas was not up in anger. So we see again the hymns so most eloquently capture what is going on with the harlot and what is going on with Judas. And the one that we would think would be the furthest from God is actually the closest, the harlot, despite her sins, because of her great repentance. And Judas, who was part of the inner circle of our Lord, falls away because of his greed, that passion that overtook him and bound him up and made him a slave of the enemy. But one of the most powerful lines of the hymn of Kasyani, which was so beautifully chanted by Dimitra this evening, says, "Do not despise me, your servant," this is the sinful woman speaking, "since without measure is your mercy." And indeed, my brothers and sisters, the Lord's mercy is without measure. We cannot articulate how merciful God is, and that it's beautifully said, without measure. O ametriton ekonto eleos in Greek. We can't measure God's mercy. We literally cannot measure it because it's so bountiful. And that is what the harlot understood and she experienced. She was sincerely repentant, and despite her great shame and her great sinfulness, she still came to the Lord. She still took that courageous step, and the Lord forgave her. It is that simple. There is nothing that we can do if we're not truly repentant of it, that Christ will not forgive. We can be free of whatever burdens and guilt and regret from our past, because the Lord's mercy is without measure. Perhaps there are people in this world, and even Orthodox, who think that the Lord will not forgive them, that indeed his mercy does have a limit for perhaps something they have done. And this evening, the hymns say that's completely false. There is nothing that will ever turn Christ away from us if we come to him in repentance. He awaits our return. If we are truly sincere, he is quick to forgive. Let us always remember that, my brothers and sisters. And even Judas could have been forgiven by our Lord with his act. That is how far our Lord's mercy goes. But Judas, we heard in the hymn, fell into despair. Perhaps he, like some, did not believe that even God could forgive him for his act. But it is the reality that Christ's mercy can cover all multitudes of sins. For indeed the Lord on the cross said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they do." May this reality give us great hope and joy, my brothers and sisters, so that we can go to Christ asking him for forgiveness, knowing that he pours his rich mercy upon us, that we will be liberated when we do so. We will be free from our burdens. And that is why we also have the great sacrament of Holy Confession. And once this ban is lifted from the shelter in place and we can come back to the church, I encourage you to participate in that great sacrament of confession so that you may experience what the sinful harlot experienced, liberation and freedom for her soul, and as a result, great peace and joy. God bless you. Again, thank you for watching with us. We continue our Holy Week journey tomorrow at 3 o'clock with the service of the Holy Unction, which again, while we are not permitted, the public is not permitted in the church, we will still have the service. And when that time comes, when the church will be open again, we will offer Holy Unction, and I will anoint everybody upon that return to the churches. And then tomorrow evening, once again, 6:30, and then Thursday morning, 9:30, and Thursday evening, 6:30. God bless you, and good strength to all of you.